Whilst you're servicing your Ford EcoBoost engine, don't forget about the PCV valve. These valves are very troublesome on a lot of different makes of cars, so let me show you how to get this out and give it a little clean. This box here is the PCV valve, and this is the PCV breather from the manifold to the valve. I should say from the valve to the manifold, because that's the way that it breathes. Lift up these harnesses out of the insulation, and then lift the insulation up, sliding it up this connector. With a 10mm socket, undo the three screws, one at the back and two at the front, here and here. They're captive in the device, so no need to lift them out and lose them. To disconnect the pipe, start at this end, unclip this tag and hold and pull it round all the way around there, and then lever up the connection. Use the same method at the valve and lift the valve straight up off the engine to remove it. Once you've got the valve off, give it a clean out with some carburetor cleaner or brake cleaner. The valve itself is in here. You may not have seen that on camera, but that cleaner came out very brown. Brake cleaner is good for this because it gets all the oils and greases off, leaves no residue, and dries very quickly. Give your valve a wipe down. Check the O-ring here. Make sure that it's not damaged. If it is, replace it. Again, you may not have been able to see that on the video, but that was coming out of there extremely dirty, so I shall give that an extra once over. If PCV valves become clogged, they cause all sorts of rough running issues, and on any turbocharged cars they can cause the crankcase to become pressurized with boost pressure, and that can very quickly wreck your engine completely because it will blow past the rings and destroy them. So perhaps every other oil change or so, it's worthwhile taking this off and giving it a clean out. You can check the main valve by blowing into it, and you shouldn't be able to blow past it. You should be able to suck past it, however, very easily. But you will, of course, get a lung full of fumes, so only do it for a brief moment, just enough to check it. Leave it sat in the sun or on top of your boiler or somewhere warm to dry for 10 minutes before putting it back. Before you put it back, just clean the mating surfaces on the top of the cam cover here, around these holes, and down inside here. From what I can see of this PCV valve, it looks to be a lot more robust than its VW Audi counterparts, which are extremely troublesome because they have a rubber diaphragm inside which rots out and then they fail. This doesn't appear to have that. The valve itself is a proper spring-loaded ball joint affair. And if you can do this job just before you change your oil, spray down these holes with cleaner as well. I'm not going to spray on this occasion because I've already changed the oil. And return the valve from whence it came, making sure that this spigot here goes into the hole in the cam cover. The two front screws first, because that gets it into position, and that makes it a little easier to do the one at the back through this rubber gasket. And just tighten down lightly by hand, because we don't want to strip any threads. Give the pipe a quick blast through to make sure that's clear, and then the pipe simply push fits into place. I suggest doing the connection at the valve first, then swing it down, push the sound insulation back into place along with the harnesses.